Welcome to the part 11 of our data structure lecture series, and in this part 11 we are going to discuss about arrays and pointers. I'm going to use pointers in arrays. So starting with the 1D array, I will paste here a program I have already written so that I can save most of your time. You can see in my program I am using int I. This is a variable declared by me for this for loop. Simply, this is a variable used in this for loop I, and it is initialized in this for loop. Then I am using int items of 5. This is an array I am declaring here, and I am also initializing the values of this array here. So index is starting from 0 and is traversing up to fourth element, fourth index. I am using this for loop here to show each and every item of an array with address and with value. So here I'm writing items. Basically, items is the name of array. Basically, this is a simple message that I'm going to print, and %d here in this for loop, I will run from 0 up to 4. So first time it will give me items of 0. Simply, this is a message items of 0, then address and the value of that particular element. This I is first time 0, and it will go here and write 0. Items of 0, and it is address and it is value. Address is given by me with the help of this items of I is the element of the array, each and every element of the array, but I am using and percent symbol with it. This will give me the element, this will give me the address of each and every element. So if I am writing items of 0 and percent symbol with this, it will give me items of 0 and the address of that, and that will be printed with the help of this %p. Items of I will give me the element of an array, 7, 9, 43, 21, and 3. So I will just show you what this program will run. I'm running this, and you can see this is simply a message, items of 0, items of 1, items of 2, items of 3, and 4. This items of 0 to 4 is written with the help of this. Then %p writes and of items of I. That means items of I is represents each and every element of an array. And if I am using and with it, it represents the address of every element. So this is the address of every element here. This is the address of 0th element. This is the address of 1th element. This is the address of 2nd element. This is the address of 3rd, and this is the 4th address. And after that, I am using %d. This is simply a value. %d is simply a value, and I am using without ampersand, I am using items of I. Basically, this items of I will return each and every value like 7, 9, 43 with the help of this %d. So it is giving me the values 7, 9, 43, 21, 3. If I am using and before this items, before the array name, it will return me the address of that particular item. Just like 7 has its address this. This address I got with the help of this and percent symbol. Okay, so this was the idea how we can access each and every element of an array, and how we can access the address of each element of an array with the help of for loop. It is possible only with the help of for loop to access the address, to access address of each and every item of an array. Printf, now I will write here %p, then I will not write items along with this. I will not write ampersand items of this I. I will write only items, only the array name. If I am writing only the array name, only name of an array without this size, without the square braces, I am using only the name of the array and printing it with the help of %p, then what will it print? It will print only the address of the first element of an array. This is the important point in arrays, that this line will print the address of this 7. This represents array name, represents only the array name, represents the address of the first element of an array. It will give me the address of the first element of an array. Actually, it is pointing towards the memory location where my whole of my array is stored, and the address of this whole array is the address of the first element of array. So it will give me the, this line will give me the address of the first element of an array. You can see this address is same as this address. So when I am using the array name, and only when I am using only the array name and printing its address, then it will give me the address of the first element of an array. I am incrementing 1 to this address and I am getting this. I am incrementing 1 to this address, I am getting this. Our computer takes 4 bytes of data for each integer value. When I am incrementing 1 to this, it means 4 bytes change. When I am incrementing 1 to this, it means 4 bytes change. Now the question here is, why this 4 bytes change occurs here? This 4 bytes change is because each address, this is one address, this is second address, this is third address, these are all addresses, and these store integer values. Each address stores one integer value. This address stores one integer value. The size of this integer value is 4 bytes. That is why from this to this, we are getting 4 bytes of change. And from this to this, we are also getting 4 bytes of change, because each address will store integer. That is of 4 bytes. But index change will be only 1. When I am incrementing 1 to this, I will get this. Increment 1 to this. When I will increment 1 to this, I will get this. Incrementing 1 means 4 bytes of change. When I am incrementing 1 to this value, it gives me 4 here. It was 0, it is giving me the 4. Basically, increment is only 1, but there is a 4 bytes change here. I will write slash n here so that new line will occur here. This was the concept when we use only the array name and print its address. It will give the address of the first element of an array. Now, I am going to dereference each and every element of an array. We are going to print the value stored at the address location of an array, at each address location of an array. So I'm going to write %d. Here I will write asterisk symbol and then array name. Array name is items. Items. When I am using only items and asterisk before this, it will dereference the first element of an array, because only items name represents the address of the first element of an array, and that address of the first element of an array is going to dereference. So it will come to the address of this 7 and will dereference it. After dereferencing this location, it will get the value of 7 here. So this line will give us the output of 7 because I am dereferencing the first element of an array. Here you can see output is 7 because we have dereferenced the array name, and the array name represents the address of the first element of an array, and the address of the first element of an array after dereferencing gives us this 7. Similarly, if I want to dereference the second element of an array, I will copy this. I will write slash new line slash n here so that new line will occur. Then I will paste it here. Now what I am going to do? I am going to dereference the second element of an array. So I have to write items plus 1. But whole term items plus 1, I have to kept in the brace so that it will dereference after giving increment to this is the first element. This is the address of the first element of an array, but I want to come to the second address of this second element of an array. So we are going to increment 1 to the first address. Then after giving increment, this whole term becomes the address of the second element of an array, and that second term is dereferenced. That is why I am using the braces here, so that brace will first reach to the second element of address of the second element of an array, then that is going to dereference. Now we are going to get the result. Here I have to use one more brace because closing brace of this starting brace. Now you can see the result. This is the second element of an array that is stored at the one location. Basically, this is this 9. As you already know, there is a gap of 4 bytes, so this was 0. This was 0, last term of this was 0, and last term of this is 4. This is the 4 bytes gap. This is the 4 bytes gap, but the address difference is of 1. We have incremented this by 1 and to get this address. That is why here we have incremented this by 1 to get the next address, and that is dereference. Basically, I have incremented 1 here, but 1 means that we are giving the 4 bytes gap, because our int occupies 4 bytes of space. You can see the result. Now similarly, I can access any element. Suppose I want to give here 2. I am using here the address of the first element of an array and increment that by 2. So I am getting the address of the third element of an array. So I am basically trying to access this 43. Basically, when I am writing here items plus 2, this means the address of this 43. Then after I am dereferencing it with the help of this asterisk, which will give me the 43. Basically, I am dereferencing the address of this location. And after dereferencing, we will get 43. You will see here I got 43. Similarly, we can access each and every element of an array. If it is only one asterisk written here, this means pointer to integer. Basically, it is an integer type array. This is an integer type array. Basically, the elements in array are of type integers. It is not of character type. It is not of any other type. It is an integer type. So here it means pointer to integer, because it ultimately contains, this item contains some address, and this pointer is representing what is located at that address. There is basically an integer value. So this means pointer to that integer. Pointer, this is the first element, this is the address of the first element, and this means pointer to that first element, pointer to the integer, pointer to this 7 integer.
Thanks for watching. Now we will meet in the next tutorial.